In the coming months before I move to Virginia, I made two trips north of Tomball to railfan spots on the BNSF Houston Sub that I hadn't been to before. The furthest north I ventured was to the town of Dobbin, where the Santa Fe and Burlington Rock Island crossed paths. Today I'd be chasing the Teak to Englewood Yard train with a colorful lineup of BNSF-9s and a rare GE B23-7 in tow. Seeing standard cab GE locomotives are uncommon anywhere, so it was nice to see this old Conrail veteran come down my line. Thanks to heavy traffic on Highway 249, Tomball was my last spot on the chase. Glad I was able to get good shots of the Dash 7 though. Here's my catch of the next day's Pasadena manifest. Karen, the Lafayette, Louisiana to Slayton, Texas manifest waits patiently to meet two southbounds in the small town. Lafayette Slayton is a daily on the BRI, and with a crew from Dayton, Texas spending many hours navigating the busy Houston terminal, crews are rarely able to take the train north of Tomball. It was interesting to see this one on the main line ready to go further north. Once at Dobbin, the train will turn west onto the Conroe subdivision on the journey to the Texas Panhandle. After the conductor of the Lafayette Slayton flipped the switch to the main, the power of the train seen to the left would run around its train and tie down for the night. The crew from Houston would take it to Teague in the morning. Before I called it a day, I went down to KCR to see the power of the KCR locals, which at this point in late May relied solely on Santa Fe and Burlington Northern painted engines. BNSF 174 handled the 115 local, 1962 handled the 101 job, as well as the KC to South yard transfer, and 2938 was used mainly for yard duties. BNSF 4405 with the KC to North yard manifest sits ready in the siding, with the crew getting on that night to take the trip to Teague and eventually Fort Worth. This was one of my favorite catches in the coming days before I left Texas. I had caught a yellowbonnet GP 60 liter before, but it was a grab shot with my iPhone. After hearing on the scanner that the 115 local would be returning to KC Yard, I rushed to Alabonson Road south of KC to film the 174, with the last ATSF painted GP 60s rapidly being sent to Topeka, Kansas to receive the H4 paint. This is likely the last one I'll ever see running.